I'm sapped. The city drains me and has no way of restoring my debts. Modern day Sodom, the epitome of decadence. I can't seem to wake up. I'm sleeping 12 hours a day and eating all organic raw foods and doing yoga exercises and trying every way I know how to restore my vitality. I'm failing miserably. One set with the jug band, and I'm a tired old man. The band is descending into hell and I can't go with them. It wouldn't be right. The dark forest are clutching at my evasive heels as I grope in. Struggle to keep my footing. I'm too tired to climb the ladder. I'm just trying not to fall. I can't still make out a dim glow from above. I look down into the murky depths, and I know it would be so easy to give in. Just loosen my grip for a moment to wipe the scum from my forehead. And it would be like the sweet, gentle, painless plunging of a dream. Down, 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 down we go. But my God, there's no getting back. Falling is so easy, but climbing takes strength and love. The bargain is tempting. Your soul. For a dream. Your weary life for a dreamlike state of painless, lifeless existence. Almost everyone has done it, though of course no one can really ever get away with it. We reap what we sow, though we're too blind to know. They're all doing it out here. It's the norm. Keep up with the Joneses. LSD can't even bring these creatures back. Everyone is dead or mad. I feel like a grave keeper in a madhouse. There is no vitality. No love. Only a thick cloud of zombie-like competition breeding the discontent and frustration which nourishes even further perpetuation of the lie. I see little hope. These people are no longer able to help themselves and have made themselves blind and deaf to assistance from the forces of light. It will take death and rebirth now. A catastrophe may be in store. Still, in their pitiful little way they try. They clutch frantically at anything which might contain the faintest promise of nourishment. These people are starving to death and eating away at their own flesh and growing weaker. Thereby, I have been sent here to witness the scene of the crime and have learned so many things here in the center of the American cancer. I'm looking into the heart of the dark well, the source from whence it flows out over America and settles like little live gobs of brown goo. Flash. Into the sky. Spanning the country. Sowing the seed of discontent. And Los Angeles is the core and I am here to learn firsthand. The dark forces are definitely at work here. The controlling power. No enlightenment save. The neon tempest. And it's an unkind circle. It takes its toll in soul, and that leaves unchecked weight and that breeds counter-effort. Always, to attempt to balance the imbalance, and the battle is all being fought on one side of the scales. And the heavy side sinks lower and lower as the lighter side diminishes and diminishes, and finally it must hit bottom and resound with a crack. And this phenomena we label catastrophe. But always these extremes on one aspect of existence attract an opposite potential. Yin and yang, and in this case it is a rise in spiritual existence to offset the overindulgence of physical existence, and this is why we are so busy. Had we lived in another time, we would have been commonplace citizens instead of rising teachers and leaders, and we were chosen from birth. And when you know your job, you must do it, or your life will only be a constant battle not to do it, because it will always be there deep down inside saying, do me. Ain't no hiding place. Liquor can't hide it. Dope can't hide it. Sleeping can't hide it. Running can't hide it. Fucking can't hide it. Screaming can't hide it. Do it. Or die trying not to. Cool yourself. Open up to all and be free, or close the door and die of suffocation. I have a shriek in me tonight and it wants out. I feel flood pressure in my innards and it swells to painful expansion. And then just as I almost seem to understand it and start to give it expression, it contracts into a tiny hard ball and disappears, leaving me feeling drained. Swoosh. Gone. I have been playing old lonesome songs on my banjo and taking trips into the past with the familiar little path notes, like stepping stones in a flower garden trail. And I know so well this trail and where it leads, but I seem to hear a voice way deep in the woods calling, come see me now, and I start to follow, but when I'm within inches of the voice, it laughs and escapes me, leaving me staring wistfully into the dark vacancy of the endless forest. And then I walk back here and it calls again in. I want to compose a beautiful song to this coming and going dance, but it leads my fingers only into itself, and I have little control. My attempts to memorize snatches of the laughing little refrains are in vain. You can't hold me down for future exploitation. I am now. And now you see my plight. I lack faith in the present because I want to preserve it for the future, and now is laughing at my folly. I say, but I'm an artist and must capture beauty. And Nya answers, then catch me if you can. And I'm afraid I can't. We must sing a song of now and praise now. Then is now. When is now? Now is now. Is when now? Is then now? And how? And when we speak of other times, we speak now. And when we speak of times to come, we speak now. And when we speak of now, we speak of other times and times to come. For now is then and now is when. And when is now and then is now. And now and then. When now is then. And now is when. Then when and then are now. Somehow. One alone needs a one. And two ones make a two. And two makes a we. And we makes a three. And three leaves a one. All alone. Needing one. To make two. To make we. To make three. Back again. Round and round. And it don't stop. The laugh makes the cry. There ain't no reason why. And when we laughed, we forgot how to cry. And when we cried, we forgot how to laugh. But we laughed and we cried. And like the breath or the tide, then it lived, then it died. See it rise, see it fall. Going no place at all. But that's life. And it can't stop. Thank God.